What's going on, guys? How are we doing today? This is Bashar Ketsu here with you, Amazon FBA seller and mentor. In this video, I'll be talking about shipping plan, the issues that I've faced with shipping plans, and those things you have to know before creating a shipping plan in 2018. So make sure you are staying tuned until the end of the video, as at the end of the video, I actually will be sharing with you guys a few things and a few issues that I've had in the past that pretty much made me or unabled me from, you know, sending new inventory into Amazon and restocking my inventory. So, a couple of things. First of all, in order for you to create a shipping plan, you have to have a listing first, right? Another thing is when you first contact your suppliers, a lot of times you have not created a listing, and by then you shouldn't have created a listing because you need to check for the cost of the product before you go ahead and even think about ordering that product, because as I always say in my product research criteria, is that the your selling price or your cost price has to be 25% or less of your selling price. Another thing is that when you first negotiate with your suppliers, first what you do to get your price or your shipping price, you tell your suppliers, or you give your suppliers your home address or just an address around your neighborhood or somewhere, you know, within the area where you want or the country where you want the shipment to be sent to. I always use my home address, you know, in the beginning I did, but then I've created many shipping plans, so I have a couple addresses for Amazon's warehouses. I've noticed that most of the times it's the same warehouse that I send to, so I'll just go ahead and use that. But it doesn't matter where, you know, as long as it's, let's say if you are in the U.S. and you're trying to send your inventory into Amazon's warehouses in the U.S., use just any U.S. address. The shipping cost should always be about the same. It may go up or down $50, but for me, it's always been the same. And then after that, once you create a listing, once you create a shipping plan, then you can, then Amazon will give you, the price, or not the price, but the address, and then you can provide that to your supplier. Now, the one and most frustrating issue that I've always had with Amazon when creating a shipping plan, especially when I am doing retail arbitrage, is that Amazon will have me sent to multiple warehouses. Now, here's the thing. When you send your inventory into Amazon's warehouse, Amazon disperses your inventory into 3 to 5 different warehouses. The reason why is because they want to keep their shipping cost down. So let's say if they know you are selling this product and this product gets ordered from 1, 2, and 3 states, they will send your inventory to those states where you know similar products are ordered from more often, just to keep their shipping costs down. That's why it takes a few days for your inventory to be available, and that's why your inventory only gets available maybe 10 or 15 at a time. Now, the one frustrating thing is that I've tried before where I want my, you know, like a lot of times, like actually earlier today, I was trying to send, 47 pieces or 47 units of 2 SKUs. One of them only had 5 units, and then the other one had the other 42. Now, I was trying to send those to Amazon's warehouse. So Amazon would ask me, or would, you know, tell me to send my inventory to 2 different warehouses, but in increments of, well, one warehouse they would, you know, they want me to send 42 units to, or 43 units to, and then the other warehouse they only want me to send 5 units to. It's a little bit frustrating, you know, like especially with the way that if you're using their partnered carriers services like DHL or UPS or FedEx. I always use UPS. It seems to be the cheapest one. So let's say UPS will charge you a 3-pound price no matter how heavy your weight is. If it's below 3 pounds, they'll charge you the 3-pound price. Their increments go by 3 pounds, 5 pounds, and 10 pounds. So let's say if your shipment is, you know, 5 pound, they'll charge you the 10-pound price, although, you know, your shipment is not quite 10 pounds. So that's how it works. So that's why I don't like to sending more, you know, to more than one warehouse. I try to send them all to one warehouse, but Amazon would not allow me. And when I called and I said, hey, this is the case, you guys are, you know, making me send 5 units to one warehouse and then 42 units to another warehouse. They said it's computer generated. Try to redo it. So what I did is I went and I deleted that shipping plan and I created another shipping plan and the same thing. Once again, the same address actually. And I did it literally for 12 minutes and it just wouldn't work. And it was pretty frustrating until I had to just pretty much do it and send them to do 2 different warehouses. But this problem is frustrating. There's a service you can actually sign up to through Amazon where you could send everything to one warehouse and then they worry about dispersing it to other warehouses. However, that service does cost. Now, when you are sending things from outside of the U.S. or you're outside of your country, like when I send inventory from outside of, like from China when I'm private labeling, typically Amazon will just have me send them all to one warehouse and then they'll go about dispersing. Typically, bigger quantities from outside of the country, they'll have you only ship to one warehouse, but smaller quantities from inside of the country, they'll have you send to the actual warehouses where your inventory will be dispersed to. Also, one thing, this is why I told you guys stay until the end. I want to share with you guys one more thing, so stay tuned. But once again, I just want to let you guys know, if this is your first time to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. I post daily about Amazon FBA and other topics when requested. Leave in the comments below where you are in the process. Let me know if this is something that you are thinking about, if this is something that you've actually done in the past. Let me know, you know, what do you do for product research? What do you do for launching your product? And I am here to answer all of your questions. Leave in the comments below anything you have. Also, smash the thumbs up button. The first link to the description is going to be to my mentor program if you guys want to inquire about that. Also, the second link is going to be to my Facebook page. I post daily about, in there. So be sure that you guys add me on Facebook. But the last thing and most important thing that I actually wanted to go into in this video is Amazon only lets you ship into their warehouses as heavy as 50 pounds per box. So make sure that when you get, especially when you're getting your shipments from outside of the U.S., like when you're private labeling, getting everything shipped from China, be sure that when you get the weight of each carton, they call it, be sure that it does not exceed 50 pounds. Amazon would let it slide one time, maybe 2 times. However, they will start charging you. Now, here's the thing. When you create your shipping plan, you put your dimensions, you put your weight. Even if it's over 50 pounds, Amazon's, the system or the shipping plan will take it as if there's nothing normal. They don't even, that's the problem, is that they do not notify you until after your shipment gets in. Then it'll say on your inventory that there's a problem or whatnot. And that, that happened to me several months ago. And when I called and I talked to them, they told me that. I said, okay, I'm not aware of that. But, I asked, I'm like, okay, but when I was creating the shipping plan, the system took it as everything is normal. Why are you guys telling me about it right now? They said it's something they were supposed to know. So be sure, any box you send over to Amazon's warehouse does not exceed 50 pounds. 50 pounds, not kilograms, 50 pounds. So be sure you tell your suppliers, if they are sending it that way, you tell them to break them in smaller boxes. But aside from that, guys, this is about it when it comes to creating a shipping plan. What are some things you need to know that are very important before starting Amazon FBA in 2018 and before creating a shipping plan in 2018? Once again, Basharka to here with you guys, Amazon FBA seller and mentor. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Leave them in the comments below. Let me know where you are in the process. Have you started Amazon? Why have you not? If you haven't, if you have, what do you do for product research? What methods and tools do you use for launching your products? Also, if you have any questions, you want me to cover any topic that I have not covered in my channel, please let me know. I am more than willing to do my search, even if I know nothing about it, and make a video about it. Basharka to here. First link in the description is going to be to my mentoring program if you guys want to inquire about that. I am running a special right now, $85 off with promo code BASHAR85, BASHAR85. I'm only accepting 50 students right now because I want to work with you guys one-on-one, make sure you guys are successful, and make sure that you guys get everything you need from me to becoming successful and locating multiple items that will make you a minimum profit of $3,000 a month each. Once again, Basharka to here, Amazon FBA seller and mentor. Smash the thumbs up button. I'll see you all in the next video. Y'all take care. Have an Amazon day. Take care.